Well, happy Wellness Wednesday to you. How are you tonight? It's 7:15 p.m. here in Florida, and I am almost done with my day, but I want to make sure I get this information out there while it's still in my brain. Because this morning I had a different subject matter I wanted to discuss, and I said to myself, self, write it down because you're going to forget. And what did I do? I forgot. So I want you to know that Cooper's phone is ringing again. That's what I need you to know. Stand by.
And I'm back.
Wasn't that fun? The one time I don't put it on vibrate, right? Murphy's Law. So, anywho, you have existing patients. Let's just get right to it. I should write everything down. That's number one. I should even write down to put Cooper's phone on vibrate before I start doing this live stream. But this is my reality. Okay. He's getting ready to go to flag football. I just gave him dinner. He had cross country. I'm running a business, lots of client needs. It's always like this. Cray cray every day. So, and I'm blessed because I made the mistake today before saying I'm just really busy with clients. Somebody goes, "Well, that's a blessing." Oh my God. Well, I say that every time I mention the fact that I have clients. I know that. It is a blessing. So, getting back to this, existing patients, clients are the best referrals. I had a conversation today with a woman who works in a medical office who doesn't understand the why of keeping track of where patients that are already existing are referred from. And it was actually a great conversation because I really opened her eyes. Now, this is someone who's been in the medical industry, working inside the medical industry 30 years, okay? And it's not her fault. I mean, she did a lot of clinical. Now she's doing a little more administrative stuff. So we have this conversation about tracking referrals. And she said, "Well, a lot of them come from the internet." And I said, "Okay, great. So when somebody calls and they say, 'I found you on the internet,' is that what they say? Or are they saying, 'I found you on Google?' Or are they saying, 'I found you on social media?' Are they saying it was a Facebook post? Are they saying it was through realself.com? Which is a place where people go to review the cosmetic procedures that's actually a part of the practice that I was talking about today." And she said, "Ooh, what is real self?" Aha. So I educated her about what that is, and she was like, "Oh my God, I have to go back and change all that information where I said this was from the internet because you want me to be specific, right?" Yes. I want you to be specific because if I know that all of these referrals are coming from real self, then I can focus my attention, money, energy on real self. So this is the best that Charlie Brown has brought over his squeaky toy. Oh, today has been so much fun. And it started at 7 a.m. with the first meeting. And now, this is life. But this is real, people. You see his tail if you're watching in the background. He hates when I do these vlogs because he wants me to play with him, talk to him. All right, so getting back to this referral. So now if I have a list of doctors that I know that patients are being referred from, when I look at my tracking log that I've talked about in another vlog before, every Friday when I look at this data, because it is data, I can see where these patients are coming from. And then I can go, "Oh, Dr. Shish Kabob, you've sent me 7 patients this week. Maybe I need to call you or send the gift card or both or visit, do something nice," because I never want to take for granted that you keep feeding my practice, right, doctor? So it's super important that you track all of your referrals down to the nitty-gritty. So that means that you have to coach your staff. You have to coach your staff how to get people to tell you exact information, like where exactly they were referred from. Because most people will just say Google, the internet. but you need to get more specific. If they say real self, that's great. If they say, I was searching Tampa Bay cosmetics, whatever it is, then you know that those search words are working for you. So the only way to really establish this, though, with your staff, I have learned, is to teach them the why. If you just tell somebody what to do, it's going to be so mundane. They don't understand, and that means they won't care. But if you tell them why they do it, a number one good reason, maybe not the one you want to start with, is if there's new business coming in, that means you have a job, right? Because if new business is coming in, we all have jobs. All right, so that's number one. Number two, new business means growth of the practice. New business means we could potentially put more marketing dollars towards something else to get even more referrals. New business means people are excited. New business means Google reviews. New business means so much. New business is the heartbeat of your practice. Because if new business isn't coming in, it's not good. So some practices get so busy that they just lose track. They're just used to being busy. Now that's a great problem, right? But the way of the world with technology and how things are shifting so much, I mean, we're all seeing it, right? This is it right here, my iPhone. And I want to get the 8 because now I saw that the 8 can take pictures like a photographer. Don't tell any of my photographer friends, but like, that's not good for them. So what are you going to do to innovate yourself, photographers? Because I've seen the pictures from the new iPhone. They're pretty darn good. Nothing like a professional picture, though. I have a lot of photographer friends. So anyway, it is so important. Your existing patients that are there can just lead to so much more, but you have to know how to massage them, track them, and massage them. So if you'd like a lesson, you could always just hire me, okay? And that's all I got tonight because we have to go to flag football. So ciao for now. Bye.